Hi, my name is Mr. Exum and welcome to my EdTech channel where I show you how to get the most out of technology in the classroom. This video shows you how to get the most out of your stylus with OneNote. This is really where OneNote comes into its own. Digital inking opens up so many more applications in the way that you can use OneNote. So let's get started. So in OneNote, at the top, you've got a draw tab, and this is really where OneNote becomes very, very exciting, because you can actually write on it like a piece of paper, and you can annotate and draw and highlight and select and do all sorts of things with your digital stylus that make it much more intuitive to use and a much better note-taking tool. So what I've got up here is I've got a few things. I've got these sort of sets of pens across the top here. Now these are all fully customizable, so if I click on the little drop down arrow I can choose which color I want. I've got more colors here, I've got loads to choose from, special pens as well, and the thickness that I like to use. Also pencils, and that's important because on the pencils they work slightly differently from the pens. Because they are sort of more touch sensitive. If I press hard and get a dark line, if I press soft and get a soft one, if I turn my pen on my side, I'm going to be able to shade. So pencils work more like you'd expect a pencil to work compared with the pen. I've got highlighter tools as well, which is going to highlight over the top of whatever else I've written or any images that I put on here, any text, any PDF, anything like that. I can use this to highlight it. And I've got more highlighter options there. And if I want to add more sort of favorite pens, I just click this plus and I can add another pen, a pencil, or a highlighter here. So I can have lots of different favorites up here. So it's very quick just to be able to jump between using, you know, one pen and another one. Now, I've also got a couple of other buttons. I've got ink to shape, which is quite good. If you turn ink to shape on and you draw sort of a rough triangle, it will automatically turn it into the shape that you're trying to do, which is a nice little feature. I've also got a ruler on there, which is helpful if I just draw some lines. If I move the ruler around, I need to draw some lines. I'm drawing a little plan and here, a little diagram. Then it will make sure I get that straight line automatically. I can switch that off. Ink to text is good as well, so if I turn that off there, ink to shape. Now if I do some writing here and then I select it using my little select tool here, my little lasso tool, which allows me to select things. If I click that and then click ink to text, it will put it into text for me. So it will actually recognize your handwriting and turn it into typed text. The maths button is a similar thing, so if I write an equation in maths, if I use the select tool to select my maths equation, there I go, and I click the maths button, then it will first of all turn it into ink to maths, so it does it in text version, so I can copy that across if I want. But also I've got some options here. I can solve the equation for x, I can show the steps that were involved with that. And finally, there's a very useful button here which a lot of people don't recognize, which is this one, insert or remove extra space. So sometimes you think, oh, actually I need to add something a bit higher up than that, and this is all now in the way. Well, you can use this to just drag down and create some extra space, removing space as well. My final tip is about the eraser. There's an eraser button at the top which you can use to press on and then write as usual, and it will rub things out. But actually is a quicker way if you're using a Microsoft Surface Pen, which is at the top of the pen, is actually an eraser, just like on the top of a pencil. So if you just turn it over and write on the screen with the top of the pen, it will rub stuff out. So there we go, get started with your digital inking. For more OneNote tips, check out my other videos in this series on my channel. For now though, thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon. See you next time.